Hi everyone and welcome. In this video, we are going to configure vCenter licensing. We're going to log into our instance vCenter server appliance. So we'll start with that. Now notice that I put in the FQDN. I did not use the IP. If DNS is not resolving this FQDN correctly, you can stop right now and go and fix that because you're not going to make it any further through the lab until DNS is working. To go in advanced and accept the certificate, that will bring us to the authentication page. We're going to use the HTML client. And we're going to log in with a username of administrator at vSphere.local, which is the administrator account that gets created automatically when you install VCSA. And we'll log in with that. I'm going to save that considering I'm going to be using it a lot. And we are connected into vCenter server appliance. We'll just knock this down and then we're going to go ahead and add the licenses in. You'll notice in fact that there's a warning up here that there are licenses that are either expired or they're going to be expiring soon. All right, so menu, we're going to pick administration. And we'll see the administration functions over here on the left. And of course, we have this one called licensing. So I'll select licenses. We don't have any licenses right now, so I'm going to add some. And I'm just going to copy and paste the licenses in here that we're going to be using for the labs. So there's one, which is for vCenter. And the other one, which is going to be for ESXi. You need to make sure that the licenses you put in are multiple lines. I'll click on next. This top one, I'm just going to put in vCenter server as the license, and the bottom one, I'll give a name of ESXi. You don't have to name them, but it makes it a lot easier for administration. And then we'll finish. So we've got our licenses that are added in here, one for ESXi, and then VCSA is in there as well. Now, the one thing we do have set up right now that we can apply a license to is our vCenter server. So if I click on assets, we'll see that the only asset we have right now in our list is our vCenter server, vCSA.vclass.local. And right now that's an evaluation mode and it's an evaluation license, so it's going to expire. I can click on select a license. I will pick the vCenter server license, say okay, and now I have a license applied to this instance of vCenter server, which has an expiry date of August next year. And that's really all we have to do as far as setting up the licenses are concerned. The ESXi licenses we'll assign when we connect to ESXi from vCenter server in a later part of the lab. That's a wrap for the video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.